Good morning. Is it still morning?
Sure.
Still morning. Welcome back to the desert out here with Wifey and Harmony, our foster dog. She is having a blast out here. Yeah, we're going to fly that thing. It is a Crash Test Hobbies Widowmaker. it was actually a gift to me from a Secret Santa last year.
That doesn't bode well for me.
What?
Widowmaker.
She's a funny one over here. so I finally got around to building it. And so I built it. I started it on the 31st. And I finished it last night. So technically it took me 2 decades to build this plane. Right? You like that? All right. That's enough of that. I didn't bring any colored tape or any paint or anything, so but I did have a bunch of stickers, so it's got basically one of every sticker in my pack, and they're most of them upside down,
but so there you can see stickers, though.
And there still are more stickers. Yes, don't worry, I didn't use all the stickers,
much to my dismay.
Yeah, her and our son both thought that I was going to use all of the stickers in my bag, which would have literally covered every square inch of foam.
Would have been better.
but I didn't want to use duplicates, you know? You don't want to be redundant.
Declutter.
So, anyway, got all the stickers on there, and now...
Time to fly.
Now it's time to fly. I have a separate BEC on this, because this ESC I'm running doesn't have its own BEC. I'm running this on an old Lumineer BL Heli 35 amp ESC, and an Emacs 2205. This is actually half the power plant from the original Angry Bee, which that was running on 6S. This is only running on 3S, and it's a 2200 3S, so it actually should be a pretty good endurance platform. So, but we'll see. Let's give it a little bit of upswing. Ooh, you know what I didn't do?
What?
I did not program dual rates.
Oh no.
Or multi-rates. So we're gonna do that really quick.
See you in a bit.
Ready now. Okay, we got multi-rates programmed in. We're gonna start on mid-rates. Take the time to do all the little things like that before you fly, especially on a maiden. It took me, what, 30 seconds to program in the multi-rates. And now if I have too much control, I can always dial it back. Quick throttle test here. Thrust is going the right way. That's always important. Let's get into it. Okay, so we're gonna throw it into the wind. Settle down. And it's a good thing I did that multi-rate before flying, because I am flying on low aileron rates right now. I kind of wish I had a current meter on board to see how much current is actually going, because I'm flying around on half throttle, which is pretty good. And thankfully, with all those stickers, I can tell which way's up. Almost full throttle. That's happy with that for a 3S wing. Which bush should we try and land it in? Sorry, honey.
Hey, missed, no crashing.
Missed all the bushes.
I have no idea where you are. Look at you doing some tricks.
This would be a really fun wing to put FPV on. That.
Of course. It's a good landing.
Success! All right, the Widowmaker didn't make anyone a widow. And I landed it twice in one piece. And had a good tumble landing on one of them. So I'm pretty happy with that. And the prop's intact. Motor's a little warm, but that's not super surprising. Just means it's not a full throttle machine. And I'm okay with that. It's nice to have kind of a relaxing wing to just tool around with for probably a half an hour. Because that's how much this battery is going to last. We checked it, and after the first flight, which was like 4 minutes, it only burned, I think, 18% of the battery. It's at 82% left. So, yeah, it could fly for quite a while. I definitely think I'm going to want to put one of my FPV cameras on it, because this will be a fun wing to do FPV on, just go zooming around the canyons. Thank you, wifey, for coming with me and sporting the flight test swag. And thank you, Harmony, for also joining us. She's enjoying the shade of wifey right now. Because it's warm out here in the desert, you know.
71.
The sun and the rocks and everything.
71 in winter.
That's pretty awesome. So, and thanks for doing the video, too. I forgot to mention the rest of the specs for this little plane. Because many people like to know those things. So here you go. It's got the Emax RS2205 red bottom motor. It's an older motor, but that's similar to any, you know, 22 size race quad motor. And it's on a 2200 milliamp 3-cell. Let's see, the speed controller was that Lumineer BL Heli S 35 amp ESC. And because that's an opto ESC, I've got a separate BEC powered by another 2S LiPo. The reason I did that is because I made the motor mount for this. I 3D printed it and I designed it myself to just slip on the back and be held on with zip ties. So I can take the motor and motor mount and ESC off and take out the big flight battery. Bless you. And then I can still fly it with the BEC and the 2S LiPo as a sloper if I want to. I gotta double check the CG on that, but I've got lead I can put in and move it around to get the CG right. So that makes this a dual purpose wing. It's powered and it'll fly for probably an hour on electric power, or I can take it out to the slope and fly it for probably a couple of days on one charge, as long as the wind holds up. What else? The prop is a master air screw 8045, and it's made for the bigger multi-rotor applications, but it's a great efficient prop for this application. It's actually the same prop that I use on my tricopter, the David Vindestal Tricopter LR. So I've got that same master air screw 8045s, and they're pretty good. They seem to be pretty efficient and not too loud. That's about it. Alrighty, we're gonna walk back and get some water, because that's a thing. Thanks for watching and hanging out, and we'll see you next time. Bye.